New Game in Order brought to you by Fullscreen.net. Make sure you take out
those pauses, man.
No, it's all good. No, I was just doing like off the cue. Make sure you check out michaelhurdle.com for your intro and graphic needs. What's going on, New Game in Order? This is Alex Lexus, a.k.a. the Juggernaut, with On Your Knees. Hit me with the assist so you can hit your applause.
Yeah, it's the Juggernaut, bitch!
Oh, yeah, baby. So we're coming at you for a podcast. I'm all off.
February 11th is what you're looking for.
Yes. Actually, well, it found me. Shit. But in any case, we're doing a consolidated show today considering the lack of news. So we're just going to kind of do like a large PSA. I tried to reach out to T-Rex, but he probably was tired from Friday Night Fights last night. You know, it was pretty intense. So with that, hold on. I got to check the volume on some of the background music so I can hear myself think. But
yeah, you gotta bring it down in the mix a little bit.
You know, again, for those who are watching, like, we have a problem with our XSplit account. Somebody decided to be like a jerk, and to whoever that guy is, you know, you just screwed over the whole team. So thank you.
Yes!
Yeah, if New Game in Order doesn't have to do a shared situation, then, you know, that might help us out. But in any case, we're going to start hitting some of the news. So here we go. And, you know, the chat is open for those of you that would like to weigh in. But let me get this web layer fixed. All right.
Really, Alex? You couldn't do this before we started.
No, well, OBS is different from XSplit, so, like, XSplit is just more reliable. You know, it's easier to do transitions and things like that, so...
Well, you know what, Alex?
You know what? I'm not even mad. But I'm making sure I got my chat in order so I can keep the screen up and running. But I'm pretty sure I'm going to keep an eye on folks in the Discord. All right, nobody in the waiting room? All right, so...
No, we do have someone in the chat, though. Blazing Kid, TES Gaming Nation.
Yes, Blazing, what's going on, brother? Yeah, I know I've been MIA for a minute. You know, I was on military duty. So,
Duty? He said duty.
Shut up. He's like, what's up, Alex? Finally, I got you. Been avoiding me. Nah, congrats. I haven't been avoiding you, Blazing. You know I love you, man. It's all gravy.
Do you really love him, Alex?
He's just giving me congratulations on the engagement. So,
You're sure it's not this type of love?
You see, Blazing? You see, that's what I'm talking about right there. It's all gravy. But
you could have your own soundboard, too. I know you used one before.
Well, yeah. If you help me get set up, we'll be straight. But, I want to give out a shout-out to the rest of the staff who cannot be here today. So we're going to get kind of started. Quick intro from On Your Knees. What you been playing, man?
I've been getting back to Elder Scrolls. I did download and beat Icy. It's a Chinese-based game. It's kind of like Bastion with the narrative action thing. It's actually kind of short. Mm-hmm. They're working on an English dub, and the chick that played Silent is going to play Icy, but she only has like a few lines in the thing anyway. But the narrator, Chinese, it sucks that you have to read the subtitles while you're playing a game.
I know.
It's actually the writing is actually pretty funny in that game. So okay. It was on sale 2 weeks ago, I think. When they get it in English, I'll do a stream of that, but I'll wait for that to happen.
All right. Excellent. And, you know, those of you who have 20XX, On Your Knees is a hell of a partner to play with. Takes Mega Man and Contra and kind of smashes it into one game, but
smashes it into a roguelike. It's more what it's about. There are randomly generated stages, items, and all that shit.
Mm-hmm. And that kind of falls into the same umbrella as Warframe. If you guys saw me streaming that, get that game. It is fantastic.
I'll be checking that out probably tomorrow. But just as a PSA, For Honor is an open beta this weekend. It was started, I think, Thursday. I only found out about the game today. I downloaded it I'll be streaming it later as a first-time thing. It looks like a cross between Medieval and League of Legends, because it looks like there's miniature bot players you see in a bunch of these games now, but it's got that medieval, chivalry, medieval warfare feel to it, where it's third-person action, PvP combat, online only.
Oh, like that Lord of the Rings game that came out. Yeah,
unfortunately, it's going to retail for $60, which I can tell you right now, it's not worth the price for an online only game. It should be. Oh, wait, I should have done this. Wait for that to finish because I can't hear it. Yeah. But yeah, it should be maybe 30 at most, probably 15 or 20.
Yeah.
So, but it does look good. A three-way faction. So, I'll be streaming that later today.
Now, you know, I wish I got caught up on this sooner, because it looks, for a game of its type, you know, like Medieval Warfare wasn't, like, graphically impressive, so
and it's
speak.
Buggy as fuck, but it was a fun game.
It, remember when we all did the fight?
Yeah, we did the four-man stream. That shit was hilarious.
And NYC Playboy got beheaded during the fiasco, and I kept hacking and slashing them. I was like, oh my god. you know? But with that being said, I think that, you know, those types of games are fun, especially if it's a, like, you know,
you gotta play with friends. That's what makes those games good.
All right, Blazing's like, which trailer you found that was better, the Colleen, aka Helena, or Injustice 2? I didn't see the Black Canary trailer yet, Blazing. You know what? I'm trying to get caught up on everything. I did see on Event Hubs that they were, you know, showing Black Canary, but you know, my fiance likes Arrow, so I'm pretty sure she'll recognize her once I check it out a little bit later. But you know, as far as the trailer, Colleen, you know, if you saw my reaction video, it wasn't so positive. It's just, I don't know the character. There's nothing to get hyped about. Oh, a new character. Okay, got it. Too easy, you know, but we'll delve into that some more. But back to For Honor. This looks rather interesting, and this is a good time to be a gamer because there's some great things in the pipeline. And, you know, from what I'm seeing, I've been missing out on a lot of stuff, but like, let's see, we have like a video kind of showing the game in action. Now, when we were playing Chivalry, Medieval Warfare, like, look at this. It's third person. Kind of has that, I wouldn't say 99 Knights feel, but like the scale. Like, you see how many like soldiers are running in the castle defense, Chris?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so this right here, like, okay, most of them are like drones, right? Like,
it's like I said with the League of Legends, you got all those drones, and those are players. I'm on a little bit of delay because I'm watching off your screen.
Okay.
But, I watched the character, the class trailer. They had the trailer for all 12 classes, and I'm just like, I gotta check this out.
Yeah.
So, it's on, I confirmed it was on Steam open beta, so I downloaded it. It's 18 gigs, so not that big of a deal to get.
Okay. Now, it's due out on consoles as well, correct?
Yeah, it's on consoles and PC.
Okay, now, will this have crossplay between each? Or is it
I don't, probably not.
You know what, we're in an age
because
that crossplay is important.
Because it's using Uplay, I think, too, but on PC it's using Steam.
They have to figure out how to get this so that, you know, because, okay, Warframe kind of pissed me off because I saw a game like that, I could have easily been like, hey, let me hook up with somebody. Like, it's like Microsoft will do a crossplay to PC, and Sony will do crossplay to PC, but Sony doesn't want to do that with Microsoft. And yeah, we know Microsoft messed up in the past, but it's about the gamers. Like, you know, if they...
Well, Microsoft are the ones that delayed the PC and console crossover, because what happened with, I think it was Halo 2 or Halo 3,
they tested
it out with, I think it was one of the Halo games, might have been something else, but they put PC gamers against console gamers.
And they got raped.
The top tier console gamers could not keep up with even average PC players.
Here's the thing with that. Now, you know, there's this scandal with Overwatch where people are using PC, mouse and keyboard on the consoles. Like, they're allowing it. You know what I mean? So some folks are complaining that, oh, it's not fair, this and that.
Well,
and
you can buy the same peripherals.
Yeah, it's
off
like,
your ass.
Yeah, so it's your tool. It's like, if I know I'm not good without an arcade stick, it's my responsibility to get an arcade stick to keep up. So it's like, nobody tells you to race a buggy versus a Bugatti. Like, if just get your tools in order.
You want the fucking Bugatti toaster. That shit's fucking awesome.
Yeah.
It's like $2,000. It's hilarious.
And it toasts your stuff super fast, but you'll get it.
Yeah, and it's freaking clear. You can actually see it toast as it works.
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable. But you know what? I get a Dynasty Warrior feel to it.
You know? Yeah, because it's got that medieval feel with all the drones. It's got that PvP action, which is certainly different. I mean, this is what Medieval could have been.
Yeah.
But he's got that graphical overhaul. And I do got to say, it's nice to see Ubisoft actually release a game that actually works at launch.
No, you know what's funny? Damn. That's messed up. But I'm seeing the way that they have this set up. It's kind of like, you know, you gain territories.
There's five game types. There's duels. There's Dominion, which I'm assuming is King of the Hill.
Yeah.
Which is probably what this game is.
Yeah.
There's 4-on-4, 2-on-2, deathmatch, and I forget what the last one was.
Mm-hmm.
There's something for everyone to enjoy. But the dueling looks interesting because it's just 1-on-1, but you got the dominion of all the bots.
Yeah. But it looks like the pacing is like Dark Souls too. Like, it's not like you can mash like Metal Gear or Bayonetta.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, at low level play you can with certain classes, but if you just mash it, you're gonna get rocked. Because there are classes that excel at counters.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
so they will
probably like a paladin class or something.
Yeah, no, there's one for each faction. Like, here, I'm on the website. What was it? Hard hitter. Hold on. There's the.
Yeah, if you want to send me a link, I can put that in the.
No, Valkyries are combos. Yeah, the warlords for the Vikings. There's a guy with the shields.
Mm-hmm.
The Orochi, that's the samurai guy for the samurai class, and
okay. There
is a defensive guy.
This looks like an arcade game, kind of. Like, you know, it's... Because usually those games, like, don't have, like, the best frame rate, you know what I mean? And I wonder what the PC requirements are to run that.
From what I understand, it's not that bad. Maybe they learned their lesson after fucking the
they're probably
the
not rendering
that was garbage.
Yeah, they're probably focusing the resources on what you see and not rendering what you don't. You know, so
yeah, that's just good. That's just good optimization.
Yeah, it looks pretty cool for now. Like, I'm thinking, New Game of Order can definitely get in and on this.
Yeah, but it's $60 a game. That's the problem.
The thing, it looks good though. I mean, it looks. My thing is, it can look good, but the gameplay has to be spot on, like Warframe. I'm giving a shameless plug to that title. It's good. Blazing says Warframe reminds me of Metal Gear meets Destiny.
That's what you just said, Alex, off air.
Yeah, I said that off air, Blazing. I said it's like Destiny, Metal Gear Rising, and freaking, like, you know, Phantasy Star Online, where you can do like Monster Hunter style link ups, and then you have the PvP, but I haven't done that yet.
Yeah, I've been looking for Neo. I'm waiting for Neo to come to PC because that I'm hearing good things about that, and it looks good.
Oh, what, for PlayStation 4?
Yeah, I'm waiting for that to get on PC.
Oh, the one by Team Ninja, the console exclusive.
Yeah.
Now, you know what? I might be picking that up just for the sake of streaming. You know, because it looks really nice. And if you remember, like, Ninja Gaiden, you know, Team Ninja is really good with doing, like, feudal ninja style.
It's not like that. There are some similarities to Dark Souls, but it that's more atmospheric type of things. It's it's got the randomly generated loot, so it is a Skinner Box type game.
Okay.
Kind of like Borderlands was, but it looks good, and it's not open world Dark Souls is, where from what I've seen, where it's, you know, got one large area to explore around, its missions with a hub. So at least that's my understanding of it. I could be wrong about.
Okay.
But it just looks good, and apparently it also had a 13-year life cycle to get produced, but I don't know what that's about. I didn't look into that.
Okay.
I just saw a headline.
Now, to get into that beta for Honor, do you have?
It's open beta for this weekend because it's launching like next week or it's launching soon.
Let me get
the release date.
No, here's the thing. Why would you even do like a open beta? Just release a demo.
It's stress testing for the
for the
servers. That's what beta tests are. They're stress tests.
All right.
Yeah, February 14th. So it launches
really
the day
on Valentine's Day. Some of you who are dating gamers that are like nerd hardcore, like, get.
You gotta get a gamer chick, that's all.
Well, yeah, this is true. Well, I'm lucky. My lady, she's open to trying stuff like with...
Are you saying that just because she's behind you?
No, she's like watching Netflix and stuff.
Yeah, but she's sitting behind you, so she can hear everything you say.
No, she has the headphones on. You know, the new Xbox controller has the 3.5mm jack, and you can put the headphones on. So
why are you lying, Alex? We know you a bitch.
Anywho... This guy, you know what? All right, hold on. For some reason, I'm getting.
I know that's late, but I just had to do that.
I know. Oh, Bushido Blade, Dynasty Warriors. Bushido Blade, interesting.
That's coming back?
No. The Blazing said he gets a feel of Bushido Blade meets Destiny. Dynasty Warriors. I said Dynasty Warriors earlier. Yeah. But I think that...
It's got more of a... That's just the atmosphere, but it's got more of a League of Legends feel, just because of all the bots on the ground.
Now, you know what? I just wish...
Or not League of Legends, Dota. Dota. That's one thing.
Okay.
Yeah, Dota.
Now, I have one of my soldiers that's actually, big on League of Legends and Dota games, so I'm like, okay, definitely something...
I play those for a bit. They're fun, but it's just like... At a certain point, you gotta be really good at just... You gotta memorize what items to buy and all that shit. It's just like, oh god, really?
Yeah, so it's like being prepared at this point.
Now, are you playing with people that know what they're doing? It's just like, really now? You get no room for growth.
Mm.
Which is... It sucks. There is a learning curve to those games, mostly with the items.
Okay. Now, you know what I noticed too? It's not... Unlike Medieval Warfare, Chivalry, like, it doesn't have the gore. Because remember, you could cut somebody's arm off and cut the leg off or something, and they'll hit them with the arrow and still in their chest and they're running around, Like, this, it looks definitely like a Sega arcade game type
thing. Well, that certainly cuts down on the graphics that they have to keep up with.
Yeah.
So that reduces the power needed to run the game.
Okay. But, I mean, like, what are your recommendations, to the new game and older audience?
I haven't played it yet, but just on the price point alone, I say don't buy it until they drop the price or it goes free to play.
Okay. Now, here's the thing, for $60?
$60, it will go the way of, what was that, the asymmetrical game with the monsters that went free to play after, like, a month? I can't think of that name.
Cousin Gokin was playing that. It was like you played as the monster, and then
That game. It's gonna be just like that. This is getting a lot of following on Twitch, but it's gonna go that route. It'll go free to play at some point, and that's when I say just hop in on it. You throw them a couple bucks for some cosmetic items, so they make some money, then you start playing it.
True. Okay. I mean, I have to say, I'm impressed by what it looks like. I just hope that the gameplay is pretty, spot on. I'm going to see if I can find another class to, check out right
and
before.
And then we can go into the next topic, maybe.
Yeah, because T-Risk, I wish he was here today, he was actually the one that first mentioned this to me as I was playing Warframe yesterday.
Mm-hmm. So with this game?
Yes. So,
I didn't even know about this. I was just on YouTube before you hopped in. I'm like, oh, what's this game? This game looks interesting. I'm like, oh, shit, I gotta check this out.
Now,
but it's, it's $60. So sad.
Yeah. Oh, now, right now, we got the, I guess, is this the Samurai or the Chinese?
No, well, the Samurai, there's the Samurai group. Yeah, that's one of the Samurai people. That's the, he's got the longest range attacks in the game.
Yeah, he has the Naginata. Weapon.
Yeah, he's supposed to be like some type of peasant who rises up to fight for the people.
And you know what's slick too?
Type of situation.
Like when you see the him fighting the opponent, they actually had a crouching tiger, hidden dragon feel to it because you see how they're getting into stance. And I'm sitting there like that looks pretty sick. But it definitely looked like an Ubisoft game. Oh, and the countering looks pretty sick. But with that ranged attack, that can get annoying really quick. Oh, and that's the duel. That's the duel. Interesting. I am very impressed by what I'm seeing here. Like, I'm really about to start looking into, doing that beta. Maybe if it's just for tomorrow, I can link up with you on your knees.
Yeah, if you want to do something tomorrow, we can. But, if you're going to check it out, make sure to download it today.
Will do. I mean, this... Oh, I'll let it download while I'm... out at the movies and doing painting. Oh man, he knocked that dude off the... What the heck is this? Alright, if they...
Oh, there he goes. I'm on a delay. I'm watching it later than you.
Wait a minute. I'm trying to think of something. There has to be a game. A way this game could be acquired, but not at the full $60. This looks promising.
I don't know. Well, I'll let you work on that.
Yeah, because, you know, New Game in Order, we still try to get these perks for the show, like getting review copies and such, but still working on it. But on your knees, you have to admit, it looks really good, though.
It does look nice, so I want to check it out. You know, if Ubisoft does something good, I don't mind throwing money at them, but I'm not paying $60 for a game like this.
All right, so we got the knight versus the samurai, or the one with the... Now, in each class, they have subclasses in them, I'm assuming.
No, just one weapon each.
One weapon each? Okay.
Now, there's a couple guys with weapon and shield, but yeah, otherwise it's just
Each. On your knees, did you see how quickly he killed the knight?
Yeah, he murdered him.
Yeah, he ran up on the
bridge. Oh, and he knocked him off the bridge again.
Oh my god, that's... Okay, at least it's realistic. Oh my gosh, what the heck? You know what? It looks fun. I think, you know, for the consoles, well, the PlayStation 4 and next one, it's good in the sense that, you know, it's not graphically demanding where, you know, you're going to get that fluid 60 frames. And if you have a PlayStation Pro, you're going to really get that, you know, the checkerboard 4K. So something to take advantage of. But for PC, I wonder what the requirements for that, because obviously you're going to have... Why he keeps knocking him? What the heck? What is this, Mortal Kombat? Finish him. He knocked him off the cliff. Here's my thing. With the
He's got to stop with that pommel strike. He's going to get fucking murdered.
Well, I'm thinking, too, is can you do 2-on-2 or something? Because
yeah, there's 2-on-2. There's 2-on-2, 4-on-4, dueling, deathmatch, which is... I don't know what that is. And then there's... the menu, which I think is King of the Hill.
Okay. You see, that's where I would be like New Gaming Order versus, like, you know, Open Challenge or something, you know. But this looks cool and definitely has that, you know, Ubisoft feel to it. Like, if you play Assassin's Creed games, like, you can definitely see the influence there. But, you know, with that New Gaming Order, we're going to go into intermission. Make sure you rate, comment, and subscribe. Check us out at newgamingorder.com for the latest and greatest. And just giving myself a visual cue for the director's cut to know when to create the segue. But, Chris, on a final note... like, what's your verdict just on visual impressions of the game?
Well, it looks very nice visually. So, I'm looking forward to checking it out later today. And I will be streaming it later today, probably after I get lunch.
Ah, cool, cool. You see? That's what you call a team player. Alright, New Game in Order. We will be right back.
Let it be known when we're off.
We are off.
T-Risk just says he's in Discord.
He's in Discord. Oh, and he just missed the good stuff.
Oh, well.
Yeah, man. That's all gravy. T-Risk, what's going on, man?
Yeah, just woke up, because apparently... The notification for this thing never showed up on my tablet or my phone.
It showed up twice for me. Like, oh,
just woke up. Wow, I can't talk. I almost slept like 3 hours last night. God damn it. You people suck. Make people sleep.
Okay, it's all good. But T-Risk, you missed the For Honor
segment.
Yeah,
is that the only one I missed?
Yeah. Yeah, okay. Because I got to keep it short because I have to keep my promises okay. And stuff, but okay. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna pick up that For Honor. That looks dope, but like at $60, yeah, though,
like I said, I'm not paying 60 for it. If it goes free to play, I'll definitely get back into it.
From what I'm hearing, like the early